All right, today at SEMA, I covered the common repair myths with aluminum repairs. So what I really wanted to achieve today is kind of dispel some of the hype or some of the myths that are out there concerning aluminum repairs. For example, a lot of people that think that you can't put body filler directly onto aluminum panels, which is untrue. If you use the correct body fillers, premium fillers, there's no problem. All the fillers that we use, for example, are tested on different substrates such as aluminum. Some of the other things I discussed was the necessity of corrosion protection on aluminum as well. A lot of people mistakenly think because it's aluminum, it doesn't rust, that you don't need corrosion protection, but there's a number of types of corrosion that can occur even on aluminum panels. A couple of the other things I talked about were properly fixturing structural panels, setting rivets and temporary rivets in place so that as you bond and rivet panels together, that the panels don't move and elongate holes or set the rivets incorrectly, so things of that nature. So in general, the program is about solving some of the problems, talking about how aluminum is different than steel, why that's important to repairs for technicians, how to deal with some of those differences, and again, kind of bring some of the level of hype down that it's a different substrate, but it's not the end of the world when we start to work on aluminum, that the shops will go through that learning curve, but eventually it'll be an easy process. So the one demonstration I did was to show how aluminum can be easily misshapen or panels can be destroyed if proper repair techniques are not used. So what I did is I took a small piece of an aluminum coupon and placed it on a metal dolly and then took a hammer and hammered right onto the aluminum panel with the dolly directly behind it. What happens when you do that is because the aluminum softer material, it actually stretch and kind of pancake out that coupon, where when you go to bend that, it'll have an oil can in there where it'll pop in and pop out because that material has stretched. So the proper technique is to use the dolly next to the repair area instead of directly behind it. So that was my demonstration today. So that was the summary for today's program. I hope everybody enjoyed it.